Om Sri Sai Ram. Can we please learn about Swami's divine discourse for students, especially about his school days?
Yes, certainly. Swami gave two discourses, and we will learn what he explained to inculcate students about his school days. Swami says, how should students conduct themselves when they behave with other students, and what are the limitations and regulations which the students should observe while they are students? I will illustrate you by taking examples from what this Raju did when I myself was a student. Puttaparthi is a small village. You all know that. This body is one which has not left Puttaparthi and had not seen other places. This body went to a place called Bukkapattanam, and there in a school they take a class which was known as ESLC. And this body was engaged in studying in that class. In those days, the public examination commenced for this class called ESLC. This public examination was held in Panvarda. In those days, to travel from Bukkapattanam to Panvarda was like making a long journey either to America or to Russia. That was the condition. At that time, there was no bus to Bukkapattanam. There was not even a road to Bukkapattanam. Later, a railway came to Bukkapattanam, and this was a great sight. Many people in the village used to talk strangely about the trains. They used to say some long snake-like thing was crawling on the rails. They also used to say that it only had one eye that was shining in front of the train. This kind of strange description was given about the train. While this was the situation, I had to travel from Puttaparthi alone. The conditions at that time were such that since I had to travel alone, the mother of this body thought that I was going on a long distance, so some trouble was may be involved. So she prepared sweets and she prepared various things for me to eat. But since there was no tiffin carrier in those days, all of this were tied up in a small bundle of cloth and it was given to me. Not only that, all the relations, father and mother, cried and thought that I was going away on a long distance. They all travelled together with me on a carriage which was driven by oxen up to Bukkapattanam. 8 of the boys together joined and engaged one bullock cart to go up to Penukonda. Among these 8 boys, there was one teacher. The roads were not plain roads. There were several ups and downs. We travelled in bullock cart for 1 mile with the ups and downs in the road. We had to get off the bullock cart, walk, then get on the bullock cart. So, it meant that actually to make a journey of 1 mile, we had to walk 5 miles. It was much easier to walk rather than getting on and off the bullock cart. And these were all young little boys. I myself was very small, and the teachers used to lift the little boys, put them onto the bullock cart and lift them out of the bullock cart again and again. In this way, those of us who started at 5 a.m. in the morning travelled all the way to Penukonda and reached there only at 9 p.m. in the night. There was no convenience nor comfort. There was no lodge where one could stay. So one could stay only in a camp. Camps were always present in the outer places of a town. So we went to the camp, carried our own provisions, cooked and ate our own food. And I used to do the cooking. All the provisions were prepared from the house, such as chutney powder and sambar powder that were given to us. We went to the camp and stayed there for 3 days, cooked food and somehow finished our examinations in those 3 days. You should not think what I am going to tell you is to get some reputation or greatness for myself. Actually, in that examination, only Swami alone got first class and passed. All others failed that examination. Because all the boys were little boys and this particular ESLC examination happened for the first time, teachers were very strict. The teachers would search the pockets of the boys to see if they were carrying any papers. Nothing was allowed inside. Pencils, rubbers and papers were all supplied by the teachers. So, This caused some confusion in the minds of the little boys. Therefore, they could not do well at all. In Penukonda and in the whole town, people heard that only this Raju got first class and passed that particular examination. They wanted to celebrate the occasion by taking me in procession on a bullock cart in the village. Saira, can you narrate Swami's incredible service in Kamalapuram to offer selfless help to others?
Sure. Swami narrated how he went to Kamalapuram for his middle school. Swami says, after passing ESLC, there was no further class which I could study in Bukkapatnam. Therefore, the brother of this body, Sheshamaraju, took this body to his mother-in-law's place in Kamalapuram for further studies. This place, Kamalapuram, was a Tamil town and was close to Kadapa, a few miles away. I was taken to Kamalapuram and there I was admitted to the third form of the middle school. The conditions were such that I could not do any work at all. I could not attend to anything. There was water scarcity and difficulty of getting water. So the first task which I had to do every day in the morning was to take a big, huge earthen pot, carry this pot to the river and bring drinking water from several miles away every day. In this manner, the whole morning was spent to go all the way to collect water and bring it back to home, which took my time until 9 a.m. Very little time was left, and that brought to me to the time of school. All that I could do was to bring in the water and go to school after having a very quick meal. In those days, there was no tiffin, so whatever food was cooked the previous night was kept overnight along with water. The rice from the previous night was simply put in salty water and left overnight. The next morning, the soaked rice had to be eaten. We just put some salt and pickles over the rice and ate the rice which had been kept overnight in water and went to school. There was not much time. We had to eat the soaked rice and pickles quickly and run away to school. In the school, there were desks in which you could place your books and also write some notes. Three boys had to sit together on one single desk. I used to sit in the center of the three places of the desk with two other boys. One of the boys was Ramesh and the other one was Suresh. They used to sit on either side of me and I used to sit in the center. This way time passed on. After 1 year, it was found that in every examination in the class, it was we three boys, myself and the other two boys sitting on either side of me, were getting the highest marks and first class. Sai Ram, please tell me about how Swami kept his promise of serving as a scout at the Pushpagiri festival.
Of course, you know, Swami went to Pushpagiri against many odds. Swami says, in a place between Kadapa and Kamalapuram, there was a place where they had an annual festival. At that time, the drill teacher in the school started a movement called the Scouts Movement. And he said that it was compulsory for all the boys to join the Scouts Movement. The drill teacher issued an order that everybody should join the scout troop and everyone had to have their khaki knickers and a khaki shirt, and on the khaki shirt they should have a medal. All this need to be prepared by us by the following week. All the scouts had to go to this annual festival in Pushpagiri and they had to do some service to all the people who would come to that festival. I did not have a single cent, naya paisa. The father to this body belonged to four families and he could not afford much. So, he simply gave me only 2 annas when I came to this particular school and 6 months had lapsed since I joined the school. So, I had spent those 2 annas in those 6 months. 2 annas were a lot of money in those days. After those 2 annas, I had no money with me. I was the monitor for the class and also a leader for the scout troop. Therefore, the teachers issued strict orders that I cannot escape, that I must be present in the scout troop and I must go to Pushpagiri. But I had no money. I was in great suspense as to how I could go without any money. But the teacher had issued strict orders that I must go along with this scout group. In those days, I had only one ordinary pair of knickers and one ordinary shirt, while the scout teacher wanted khaki knickers and khaki shirt. As soon as I would return from school, I would wrap myself with a white towel and wash the only set of knickers and shirt. And in order to iron these things, I used to get a brass vessel. In a brass vessel, I would put some coal, make it hot, and then iron the clothes around with this brass vessel. And then take the knickers and shirt and put them under some heavy weight like a steel trunk so that they would get flat. And I would wear them the next day. I did not have enough money to get a second set of knickers and shirt. I had been getting on with only one pair of knickers and shirt. How could I get an additional pair of khaki knickers and shirt? I didn't want to go and tell the teacher that I only had one pair and also that I didn't have khaki knickers and a shirt. This was because that will reflect on the honor of my family. Since I could not tell the drill teacher these facts, I was going to quit going to Pushpagiri. In this way, I had been hesitating and discussing between various alternatives. Under these circumstances, I made a good plan. I said that I was not feeling well and that there was another boy, Ramesh, who was my assistant and would take my position. But this boy who was sitting next to me, Ramesh, somehow came to know that I had some difficulties and that I was planning to get out of the situation. He went to his father and said, "Father, I very much want the khaki knickers and shirt. They are very nice. Please make not just one set, but two sets for me." And he had the same height and stature as me at that time. While this was so, the other boys learned that I was getting out of the plan and they started planning not to go too. The pressure from the other boys started increasing. They would come and say, "Raju, if you don't come, then we won't go." Meanwhile, Ramesh managed to get an extra khaki uniform from his father and he wrapped it in a piece of paper and wrote a note saying, "Raju, I am leaving this extra uniform for you. You must accept this extra uniform. If you don't accept it, I will commit suicide. Please accept this from me." And he put it in the desk where I used to put my books and left it there. Ramesh also wrote in that note, "Raju, you are like a brother to me. You must accept this dress as a brother would accept." When I saw the note, I just tore up the note and wrote another note in reply stating, "If you really want my friendship, this kind of giving and asking me to take gifts from you is not right. This will spoil our friendship, Ramesh. If you want to be my brother, do not give such gifts. Let us not give and take between us." When I wrote that note, that boy Ramesh could not do anything and took back the khaki uniform. There were 3 days left till the festival was coming to Pushpagiri. The school was closed for those 3 days so that the boys could prepare to go to Pushpagiri. I was planning not to go, although I was telling them that I was also coming, but somehow I had to find an excuse so that I did not have to go. But if I had said that I had a temperature, then they would check me with the thermometer and see that I had no temperature. So I thought that the best thing for me to do was to pretend that I had a severe stomachache. I told them that I had a severe stomachache and that I won't be able to go. The boys were all going in a procession to Pushpagiri and the teachers were also there. They all came into the house and they said, "What happened? Why is Raju not coming?" The brother of this body told him, "No, Raju is having a serious stomachache and he cannot join." Finding these people had come, I pretended that I had a serious stomachache and started groaning with pain. At that time, a teacher by the name Janab Mavkan came inside and when he did, I pretended to be even worse and started groaning very much because of the stomachache. "Oh, Raju is ill. All we want is for him to get well. Let's not pressure him to come with us." So saying, Janab Khan left the place and along with him, all the teachers and the students also left. Each of the boys had contributed 12 rupees. 10 rupees were for the bus fare and 2 rupees were an extra pocket expense while they were there. Regarding food, each one had to make his own arrangements. So each boy gave 12 rupees. I did not have 12 rupees. So there was no question of my going around with that group. But as soon as the group left, my stomach ache disappeared. Now the problem was, how could I go to Pushpagiri? I had to go somehow. So I had a plan. I knew that I had completed my class. I also had passed. I had a complete set of textbooks such as mathematics, history and geography. I never used them, so they were in new condition. I knew a poor Harijan boy who had just entered a class out of which I had passed. I went and offered the set of books and for sale to this Harijan boy and told him, although they are new, since you are a poor boy, I would like to give them to you for half the price. But even so, he did not have the money. I told him, never mind, take all the books, but give me 5 rupees, that is enough for me. I just want to get 5 rupees, which I need. I don't want more. I got 5 rupees from him for the textbooks. The boy was very happy that he got all the books in new condition for just only 5 rupees. In those days, we did not have 1 rupee notes which you see today. So, he had to bring a large amount of change, coppers and so on for 5 rupees which was given to me. Where could I put all this change? I had to hold all this change. There was no pocket in which I could hold all this change. The only way for me to carry this change was to look at my torn shirt and tear out a piece of cloth and put all my change in this piece of cloth and tie it up. While I tied up and tightened the bundle, the cloth itself got torn and all the change fell on the ground and got dispersed and scattered. Then the lady of the house came and saw all the change. She said, where did he get all this money from? Have you stolen this money from my house? In many ways I tried to prove my innocence. I brought the boy who purchased the books from me and made him explain that he gave me the 5 rupees of change, and in spite of all his efforts, the lady would not believe it. Instead, she gave me a few blows and asked me to leave. Next day, I thought that if I do not go to Pushpagiri, people would ask me, what happened? Are you not going to Pushpagiri? Why are you roaming outside your house? And that would bring the reputation of my family out into the street. I did not want to do this. Also, I did not want others to know anything about what was happening in my family and to me. So, I immediately left my house and walked 9 miles to the place where the annual celebration was being held. Sairam, was he able to reach Pushpagiri by walking?
Yes, but he went through a lot of struggle and finally he made it. Swami continued, it was a full moon day and many people also wanted to go and visit the celebration at Pushpagiri and were walking on the road because it was a nice full moon night. I also walked with them because it was very pleasant to walk on a full moon night. That night, I reached Pushpagiri. Those were hot summer days. And I walked 9 miles. I was very thirsty. And in those days, it was not easy to get drinking water. The only way in which you could get water was where people would wash their cattle. For the purpose of washing their cattle, people used a small tub that contained some water. But that water was dirty. Since I was so thirsty, I had to drink a small quantity of this dirty water. And when I went there and quenched my thirst with this unclear water, I found on the stone or slab, someone had left a bundle of bidis and one anna. Bidis are a kind of country cigarettes. I saw this and took hold of these bidis and one anna and turned around to find if the owner was anywhere nearby. I asked people, does this belong to you? Does this belong to you? But no one answered. And evidently it was not claimed by anyone. So I took these bidis, broke them into bits and threw them away under the sand. One anna would bring 4 quarter annas. So I changed the one anna to 4 quarter annas. Now I had only 4 quarter annas with me. I had to spend several days with these coins. How was I going to stay there with 4 quarter annas? Then I did something wrong. I went to a place where a game of dice was going on. They had dice and they state money on a particular point. They throw the dice. When the dice is favorable, they give back more money. So I started playing the game. And as soon as I played the game, I found the returns were very good. Within a few minutes, I made a total of 12 annas. When I got 12 annas in my hands, I thought I should not become over greedy, so I stopped playing the game. Then I calculated that since I had to stay for 10 days at the rate of 1 anna per day, it would be enough for my food. I had 2 annas extra, and I could take some fruits and flowers when I went back home. So I calculated that 12 annas were sufficient. Life was cheap. With 1 copper bottu, a copper coin, in those days one could get 3 large sized dosas. And in that region of Kadapa, dosas are served with red hot chili, which can fill one's stomach, and that was quite enough. So I calculated that I would have 3 dosas, and I had 3 dosas with a quarter anna along with masala and chili. I had 11 and 3/4 annas, which was out of the 12 annas I had gained, and I calculated that everything would be all right. After eating these dosas, I left. How can I keep it anywhere safely? In the plan, I packed the change in a piece of cloth, tied it up into a small bundle, then I dug out some sand and kept the bundle under the sand and used the sand mound as a pillow. I put my head upon this and thought that it would be safe. Having been tired from walking the long distance, I just slept. Someone had noticed that I was putting this money in a piece of cloth and hiding it under the sand and putting my head on the sand. He quietly came after I slept, dug out the sand and took away this change. There was nothing I could do. I had no money and therefore I had no food. But the next morning I found all the boys who were the members of the scout group in their khaki dresses. All were located in different places to attend to duties for the pilgrims and visitors. For 3 days I had no food. I was carrying on like that. In the meantime, Ramesh, who came around with the scouts, had somehow sensed this. He started coming to me without other people noticing it, because he knew I did not want other people to notice it. He would come, he would bring one dosa or something to eat, and he would give it to me, and this is how he managed for those days. The festival of Pushpagiri was very famous in those days, but I had to go back home now that the festival was over. When I was about to leave for home, my sister-in-law, wife of Shashmaraju, was in the family way, so I could not go empty-handed because they would ask what I had got from Pushpagiri. So I asked this boy Ramesh, "You give me a loan. I will take a loan of 1 anna from you, and when I go back, I will return the loan back to you. Give it as a loan and not as a gift." With this 1 anna, I purchased some fruits and flowers and took them home when I returned from Pushpagiri. Thus, Swami narrated his trip to Pushpagiri. Jai Sai Ram.
Jai Sai Ram.